take a 1 minute out. We'll be right back.
October 9th, Randy Russell gets set to kick off for the Panthers, who will be operating right to left on your radio dial to open this ball game. Once again, Texarkana's outstanding tailback, Donyen Smith, didn't dress out tonight. He will not play. But Texarkana not short on talent at the tailback spot. Charles McClain stands at the 5-yard line, and Randy Russell gets to tee it up, and the pep stepper comes to life right below us. Good crowd on hand. Watch the 2-3 Panthers open up conference play against another top 10 opponent. Here we go. Randy's into it. High short kick. It's going to be fielded by Armando Barry on the 25-yard line. Cuts across the 30. Watch out. He's down at the 33-yard line. Check that. Returning it for Texarkana, DeMarcus Weekly. And Texarkana will take over at the 33-yard line. Texarkana dressed in their road white jerseys, maroon numbers, maroon pants. They'll operate from the left hash mark, and they come into this ball game 4-1 record. They'll send one receiver wide to the right. That's Drew LeGrand. Baxton and I, McClain, the up back, Marcel Dean, the tailback. Behind quarterback Rod Smith, turns, pitches the Dean, running left side. Good yardage as he crosses the 33 to the 34 for a gain of 6 yards and brings up a 2nd and 4 on the first carry. Kirk Shelnut and Tommy Jumper, Jeff Reed, getting the start on defense with the tackle.
Yeah, Dwight, the injury that forced the Panthers to make quite a few changes. We started out with a pitch to the outside. With Donyen Smith, the Razorbacks are more of an inside team from the tailback, but with Marcel Dean back there, they like to go outside.
Second down, 4 yards to go, and into the ballgame, Armando Barry. He comes near side of the field to give to McClain right up the middle. He'll have the first down as he gets close to the 45-yard line. They'll spot it at the 44, and Texarkana two running plays and an early first down. We're just a minute into the ball game, and the Razorbacks have their first down of the ball game.
I was talking to one of the riders from Texarkana before the game, and he was saying, don't expect the Razorbacks to throw a whole lot. The big passing game for them will be 10 tosses.
The Benton defense, five-man front. Right behind them, pair of linebackers, back still in an eye for Texarkana. The give will go to the up back. McClain, he's stuffed at the line of scrimmage and thrown back. Bobby Van Cleve and Greg Mundy in there for the hit. And it'll bring up a 2nd and 10 situation for Texarkana. You ask, can they pass? Rod Smith, understand their quarterback, with a rifle.
He has a good arm, Steve. Those who might have made the trip down to Texarkana last year will remember Smith playing some. He was a part-time starter. And he shows a good arm. The question will be, can he hit his receivers?
Now call it 2nd and 11 as they spot the ball at the 44 of Texarkana. Razorbacks opening drive. Smith, the draw call to McClain. He's tripped up at the line of scrimmage. Good defensive play by Scott Long. He tripped up McClain at the line of scrimmage. Didn't go for the draw at all. And as a result, Texarkana in a passing situation. 3rd and 9. The ball at the Razorback 46. They need to get to the Benton 45 for a first down.
Scott Long is continuing to play well at defensive tackle. Coach Fite, we were talking about the defense the other day, and he just kind of says that, he says, you kind of forget about Scott being over there, but he just does an outstanding job and has done all year long.
Averages 10 tackles a ball game. He's the leading tackler on this Benton Panther team. Smith rolls out wanting to throw on 3rd and 9. He's hit and dropped in the backfield. Kirk Shelnut will get credit for the solo sack, and the Benton defense impressive on the first opening series. And Texarkana will have to punt the ball, 4th and 15. Shelnut shooting in from his linebacker spot, 1-on-1, and drops Smith.
Smith was rolling to his left, and Barker did a good job. The defensive end on that side with containment, and Kirk shot through on the blitz and got the tackle. It's a big play for this team that needs some confidence early.
Oh, I came to C.W. Lewis Stadium tonight feeling good and feel better after this first series. The snap back, the punt is off. Jumper back deep. It'll be fielded by Jake Goheen at the 30. Cuts across the 32, and that will be it. Jake Goheen down at the 32-yard line, and that's where the Benton offense will take over. 8:50 to play in the first quarter. First conference game of the year for both Benton and Texarkana. Around the state, this would be a major upset tonight, considering the way Benton has played the last 3 weeks, but I really feel the guys in maroon think they can win this ball game tonight.
Benton seems to be showing a little confidence. They've got a lot of changes they've made, and we'll just have to see how the offense does.
Greg Little starting at fullback in place of the injured Greg Holmes. Backs in a bone behind Tommy Jumper, and Little gets the call, not much over the left side, maybe for a gain of 2 yards. David Potter, a 175-pound sophomore for Texarkana, covers Little to bring up a 2nd-and-8 call for Dwight Feit. And into the ballgame, Monty Cornwell, relaying the play to quarterback Tommy Jumper. And a quick timeout on the field called by the officials. Jeff, opening series tonight, we get a look at a revamped offensive line, almost like Dwight Feit, due to a few injuries, is really calling the hoshes and has loaded up that front line.
Yeah, but there are some new faces in there, but it's the offensive line that he has a lot of confidence in.
2nd down, 8 yards to go. Cornwell goes wide to the right side. Jumper down the line of the option. Pitches back to Shelnut, hit at the line of scrimmage and dropped. Good defensive play rushing up from his cornerback spot by Shelby Rayfield, 153-pound junior. Shelnut hit immediately after he received the pitch. Dwight Feit now faced with a 3rd-and-8 situation, and in comes Jake Goheen. The ball on the near side of the field, closest to the Benton sideline. Right away, we see them run the option, and Dwight Feit said that's something tonight. They would do more, string out and run that option.
He is looking to run the option, and it'll be interesting to see how the success they will have against a team with Texarkana's quickness.
Scott Long, tight end right side. Scott with 13 catches on the season. It's 3rd-and-8. The give to Little. He's going to be close to a 1st down and tripped up as he crosses the 40 to the 41. He's going to come up about 1.5 yards shy, and on comes the punt team. But Greg Little had an opening, and had he not slipped and fell at the 40, I think he would have had a 1st down.
Oh, he'd have had more than a 1st down, Steve. He was past the line of scrimmage and was in the secondary. He just fell. And it was fortunate for Texarkana because it puts Benton in a punting situation.
Scott Long back at the 25-yard line. Twin receivers back deep for Texarkana. They stand at the Razorback 25-yard line. Scott averaging 33 yards a kick. The snap is good. Long plenty of time. End-over-end kick will bounce at the 25, and it's going to roll dead at the 24-yard line. So the first punt of the night, good for Benton, considering last week when Catholic High's Mark Walls took it all the way to put Catholic High on top early, 7-0. We'll get our second look at the Benton defense now.
Steve, I think we may have seen a new strategy there on punting. It looked like Scott was punting it away from the returners and just hoping that they could move the ball downfield and down at some place.
Second look at the Texarkana offense. They started on their first possession from their own 28-yard line. They'll start this time from their own 24-yard line. The backs still the same. McLean and Dean in the eye. Smith turns, pitches the Dean running left side. He's got a blocker out in front. Now cuts it upfield, and he is going to be nailed after a gain of 2. There goes the football. And Texarkana will cover it, but a good job of pursuit by the Benton defense, hemming up Dean for maybe a gain of 2.5, and they're doing what they have to do. Now they're going to call it a gain of 4 and spot the ball out near the 30-yard line. But they're doing what they have to do, call it a gain of 5. 2nd down and 5 yards to go of pinning Dean in and making him come back to them.
Yeah, and they did a good job, but they didn't finish the play. Dean kept showing second effort and got that extra yardage that what didn't look like it was there.
2nd down, 5 yards to go. Smith turns, gives the Dean left side. He's stuck at the line of scrimmage, spins forward, close to a 1st down. Looked like Roger Barker might have been there on the initial hit. Let's see where the officials spot the football. Texarkana has to get to the 34. They're 1/2 yard shy. 3rd down and less than 1 yard for the Razorbacks. Early first quarter, 5:20 to play. No score, Texarkana and Benton. Conference opener for both squads. Razorbacks break the huddle. Drew LeGrand comes wide to the right side. Double tight end set, McLean and Dean. The give goes to Dean right up the middle. He'll have the 1st down as he crosses the 35 and works his way to the 38-yard line. Kirk Shelnut, one of several Panthers, in on the hit. And they'll move the chains. And the Razorbacks with their 2nd 1st down of the ball game. 1st and 10 at their own 38-yard line. And Jeff, this is the kind of ball Dwight Feit would rather see, make him grind out those 1st downs rather than that big play.
Texarkana has, with his speed, has the capabilities of striking in a hurry.
1st and 10, reverse set up. They'll fake the reverse. Dean breaks the tackle and skips across the 45 to the 46. Shane Smith was there. He might have been fooled initially by the reverse, fake reverse. They had LeGrand coming flying around from his split end spot. And Dean just faked the handoff and kept it. Smith had a hit at the line of scrimmage but couldn't wrap up, and as a result, Dean squirted for 7 yards. Call it second and three, the ball at the 45.
Fortunately, Smith got enough on him to trip him up, or he'd have had a big yard.
Now LeGrand comes wide to the right side. Monty Cornwell right across the line of scrimmage, staring him in the face. The give goes to McLean right up the middle. Good job by the interior defense. Call it maybe a gain of a yard or a yard and a half. Several Panthers. Bobby Van Cleve coming up that linebacker spot put the finishing hit on him. Caught third down and now less than a yard for Texarkana. And in with the play, Hernando Barry with the play from Coach Bill Reed. Inside 4 minutes to go, and really a big play for Texarkana.
It really is, and a bigger play for Benton. If the defense can stop him again, that'll be a little more confidence this team that needs confidence so badly will get.
Armando Barry goes wide to the left side. Smith turns, gives. Dean will have the first down. He's in the secondary, slips and falls at the Benton 41-yard line. Lost the football after he hit the ground. No fumble, but Marcel Dean, showing his speed, broke that to the Benton 41-yard line. Had Marcel not slipped, he could have been gone. And Texarkana in business now, first and 10 at the Benton 41-yard line.
Steve, Dean has a little more quickness than what I was led to believe. It looks like he can cut and stop on sharp angles.
Little equipment timeout, Kelsey Dedman. Good to see him back in the lineup. 6'4", 265 pounds, trying to go both ways tonight. Missed a few weeks with a pulled hamstring, but he's back at it tonight, as is Randy Russell, who's playing with a cast on his left wrist. First and 10 for Texarkana. The give left side to McLean. He's in the secondary, has a first down, still running hard. Finally, thrown down at the Benton 23 by Randy Russell. Good job by the left side of the Texarkana offensive line, and a good job of power running by Charles McLean, a 165-pound senior. Once again, mentioning Donyen Smith, over 600 yards for Texarkana on the season, not dressed out tonight. But early on, Jeffrey, the Razorbacks not missing Donyen.
They're not. Their backs are doing a good job of keeping their legs moving when they get hit, and they're not going down easily. Benton's going to have to do a better job tackling.
Five-man front for the Panthers. First and 10 for Texarkana, operating left to right on the Benton 23. Right side, Dean. Hit at the 21 and dropped right there. Kelsey Dedman. Oh, it's good to call that name. Second down, 8 yards to go for Texarkana. Razorbacks threatening to break a scoreless tie. Texarkana now officials timeout as once again more equipment trouble on the Panther side. And that's no surprise with all the people even on the field banged up, all kinds of pads being used tonight.
Steve, so far Marcel Dean on 7 carries already has 39 yards.
Well, the biggest statistic to this point, still a couple of zeros on the scoreboard, although Texarkana has really owned the first quarter. Benton had 3 shots, couldn't come up with a first down. Texarkana has had the ball the rest of the quarter. Second down, 7 yards to go, the ball on the Benton 20-yard line. Smith to throw. He's got time, now scrambles right side, fires. It's going to be caught at the Benton 8-yard line. Fine reception as Smith fired low. Bill Lawless, 187-pound senior, just picked that one right off the ground for a fine catch.
Rod Smith showed a little the strength he had in his arm. He didn't even hardly rear back, and he just flicked that one over there, and it was a good little pass to the tight end who made the catch for the first down.
So Texarkana successful on its first pass of the night. First and goal on the Benton 8-yard line. No score. Inside 2 minutes to play in the first quarter. Double tight end set. McLean and Dean behind Smith. It'll be Dean right side, inside the 5, burrows down to the 2. All kinds of Panthers combining for the hit. Lincoln, Long, McGee, Van Cleve, but call it a gain of 6 and call it a second and goal to go. They'll mark the ball now at the 3-yard line. Texarkana, anything less than 7 points here would be a victory for Benton. 1:20 to play in the first quarter. Drew LeGrand goes wide to the left side. Monty Cornwell follows him out there. Back's eye tight behind quarterback Rod Smith. Smith, long count. Now gives the Dean running right side. He's stuck at the line of scrimmage and nailed. Call it maybe a gain of a yard. Defense, a good job of reacting. Van Cleve, Mundy, Dedman, good job of gang tackling. Dean, really a slithering back. He keeps the feet moving. and is going to be dangerous on second effort plays tonight. And a big third and goal to go as they spot the ball at the two.
This is a real big play here. Benton can force them to, if Benton can hold them here, it'll be interesting to see what Texarkana would do on fourth down.
Once again, two tight ends set. One receiver wide to the left side. The pitch left side to Dean. He's hit in the backfield. Now they're going to stop the play. Flags are down. And I believe the dead ball foul, too much time, will go against Texarkana. No, it'll be an illegal motion call. Turns a third and goal to go at the two into a third and goal to go at the seven, and certainly changes Bill Reed's thinking.
It changes things a lot, but Steve, I wouldn't be a bit surprised to come back and see Texarkana run the same play, pitch the ball to Marcel Dean and let him try to outrun him to the corner.
We got to see enough of that play before the flag was thrown to see that it was almost going to be a one-on-one situation between Bobby Van Cleve and Marcel Dean. He did a good job of shooting across from his linebacker spot, reading the play. And if they let it go, my bet was on Van Cleve. Bobby, a very short tackler. Averages 9 a ball game. Here we go. Inside 30 seconds to go in the first half. Texarkana third and goal. Yes, it's the pitch to Dean left side. He's got a blocker in front. He goes for the corner. He'll get there. Marcel Dean in the end zone. Fine block by the fullback out in front, Charles McLean. And Jeff, you called it. They used the open side of the field. Dean used his blocker well. McLean strung it out, and McLean did his job, and Dean did his. And as a result, Texarkana is up 6-0.
Steve, I think Benton had to play played better the first time. Or maybe Texarkana pulled more people. It seemed when they got the ball to Dean, he had more. They had the numbers in their favor, and he just followed his blockers into the end zone.
Texarkana having all kinds of trouble. Rod Smith, quarterback, kicks, and now Texarkana will have to call timeout while Rod Smith gets his kicking shoe on. While his timeout on the field, we'll take a quick 30-second break. Your score, Texarkana 6, Benton nothing. Yep. Texarkana preparing to attempt the point after. Score in the ball game, 6-0. Marcel Dean going 8 yards on a third and goal for the score. Now Armando Berry will get the hold for quarterback turned kicker Rod Smith. The long wait, the snap, the hold is down, the kick is high and right down the middle. Texarkana as the point after. Your score, with time running down in the first quarter, I think 1 second, is Texarkana 7, your Benton Panthers nothing. Quickly, let's take a little visit to Bob Edmondson, who's standing right there on the Benton sideline.
Well, Steve, the touchdown for Texarkana certainly hurt the Panthers, both on the scoreboard and both with their spirits, but things are getting back up right now as Robert McNeely, number 24, plays in the backfield for the Panthers, going around trying to get people riled back up. So it's early in the ball game, and the Panthers will definitely be back. Steve, also, I'm going to try to get some interviews throughout the ball game with Greg Holmes and Rusty Winfield and some of the Panthers that are injured this evening.
Well, you shouldn't have trouble finding the injured Panthers. There are plenty tonight. Benton, a banged-up team. And hopefully they have enough hosses to take care of Texarkana tonight. Just a single second left on the first quarter clock. Rod Smith now getting his paces down. Back deep, getting his first varsity look on the kickoff team. The white hat, Jamie Jones. He stands at the 3, flanked by Robert McNeely at the 4. And let's see if Smith aims for that white helmet. He does. Line drive. No, it's going to come short. Randy Russell, the big guy, plowing across the 20, and he gets met and thrown down hard at the 25-yard line. And the first quarter, if I can reach around and look around a pole, is over. Your score after a quarter, Texarkana 7, Benton nothing. Let's take a quick 30-second break. Plays, 76 yards. Marcel Dean, 8 yards for the touchdown. The story of the first quarter, the Texarkana offense just grinding it down the field against the Benton defense. Your score, 7-0. Texarkana, the Benton offense, gets its second shot. Now operating left to right on your radio dial, Tommy Jumper. try to make things go. He's the catalyst to this Benton wishbone attack. Tommy on the season. He's completed 40% of his passes. He'll roll right, wants to throw. He's got the time, fires deep down the sideline. McNeely is there, overthrown and incomplete. Robert looked like he was running almost a fly up the left sideline. It was actually behind the secondary, but the ball was just angled a bit out of bounds, and McNeely, maybe if he was Scott Long's size, would have had a shot at the football.
It looked like Tommy Jumper may have lost sight of Robert running along the sidelines over there because he lofted the ball real high. And if he had thrown it long, I think Robert could have run under it because he was open.
Now, Robert played receiver last year, has two catches this season for 29 yards. The majority of Benton's passes completed have been caught by Scott Long, 13. Jumper options near the side of the field. He's got an opening. Now he is grabbed by the shirt and thrown down at the 27-yard line. Fine defensive play made by Texarkana. Jumper, once again, a breakaway jersey away from breaking that one. The option was set up well, and just a fine defensive play by Texarkana's cornerback, Tim Denman.
Yeah, and the pitch was there, but I don't think Tommy could get rid of the ball, and he was thinking about protecting it. So now we look like we got a passing situation.
Third and eight. The ball's at the Benton 27. They need to get to the Panther 35 for a first down. Scott Long is tight end right side. Monty Cornwell, one receiver, split wide to the left side. Now Jumper, options near side of the field, pitches to McNeely. Short yardage as he's thrown out of bounds at the 30-yard line. That play just never really developed. You run that option to the short side, you run out of real estate real quick. You got to make that cut almost immediately, and there just wasn't there for McNeely. And as a result, Scott Long will have to punt again. So the Benton offense really putting the pressure on the Panther defense. Two series and three plays each.
That's right. Now Benton needs a big punt to change the field position around because Texarkana is looking like it will get good field position after this change of possession.
Hermendo Barry stands back to 33. The snap bounce, but Scott gets it off end over end. It's going to hit and take a Benton bounce inside the 40, and it's going to be down at the 37-yard line. And that probably the, let's credit the fine hands of Scott Long with getting that punt off. You seldom mention the deep snapper unless he gets off a bad one. And Rod Balding this season has done a fine job snapping the football. And that time he's just thankful that he had Scott Long back there receiving that kick, receiving
Scott,
the snap.
Scott did a good job of saving it.
So Texarkana takes off the football at their own 37-yard line, best field position they had all night. Early second quarter, Razorbacks on top, 7-0. Backs in an eye tight behind Rod Smith, and once again the flags are flying, and it looks like Texarkana either motioned or took too much time, but this will go against the Razorbacks. Offsides against the Razorbacks, it'll bring up a first and 15 situation. Two mistakes in execution early by Texarkana, and Bill Reed, knowing Bill Reed, is steamed on the Texarkana sideline.
Reed has always had well-drilled and well-executing teams, and see, early mistakes that are just mental mistakes, I'm sure that's not exactly pleasing to him right now.
The Benton defensive front, right to left, Roger Barker, Scott Long, Greg Mundy, Kelsey Dedman, and Randy Russell. Now Shane Smith comes up to the line of scrimmage, pitch right side to Dean. He turns the corner at the 25, 30, 35, out close to the 40 before he's thrown out of bounds by Kirk Shelnut. They'll mark it at the 42-yard line, and a big gain for Marcel Dean, and it'll bring up a second and five, called a gain of almost 10 for Marcel Dean, who turned the corner, the wide side of the field, and really erased that five-yard penalty.
It looks like when Texarkana has the ball to one side, they're going to pitch it and let Dean run to the wide side.
Texarkana, definitely with the speed advantage tonight. Drew LeGrand, wide to the left side. That's the open side of the field. Smith gives on the draw to McLean. He's stuck by Kirk Shelnut, but not before he reaches forward for what looks to be a Razorback first down out at the 47-yard line. All depends on where they spot the football. And taking their time, it looks to be plenty for a first down, and now they're going to bring on the chains. First down or no first down, I'm impressed with fullback Charles McLean, a very deliberate runner, picks his holes, and both McLean and Dean have shown good second effort runs. They made that first down by a good foot and a half. Maybe they wanted to exercise the chain crew there, but
maybe you wanted to see if they were in the game over there. They were asleep. Steve, talking about Charles McClain, I was talking to a guy that writes for the Texarkana paper, and he says McClain's not really a fullback. He's really just a tailback who they have in the fullback position.
Texarkana's back's in the eye, really tight to quarterback Rod Smith. Option right side, Smith will turn it up. He's stuck at the line of scrimmage by Heath Nix. Call it a gain of two. Heath shooting across from his left tackle spot. It'll bring up a second and eight situation. Texarkana at its own 49-yard line. Nix, a sophomore, fifth on the tackle chart, and has really done a good job since being inserted into the lineup.
Coach Fite has been real high on this sophomore class, and they continue to impress, and they continue to get more experience.
Side by side, it's Nix and Mundy, two really talented players who are going to make an impact probably around the state as seniors. Second down, 8 yards to go. Texarkana trying to build on a 7-0 lead. Smith wants to throw. He's got time. Here comes the pressure. Loops it. Cornwell is there and makes a great interception at the Benton 28-yard line. Oh, Monty Cornwell was out there and had to extend his arms. The guy is 6'4", and that was just a beautiful interception for Monty Cornwell, his first of the season. And that's a big moment for the senior and a big momentum builder for the Panthers.
It really is. Monty made an excellent play there. Kind of helps being a receiver. He's caught a lot of passes in practice, and he showed good hands there. Maybe Coach Pite will see that and throw it to him on offense now.
He stretched his hands up high over his head, no help from his body, and made a beautiful catch. So Texarkana gives up the football. Benton via the turnover. First and 10 on its own 28-yard line. The pitch. Good running room from McNeely. Near side. He'll have a Benton first down as he crosses the 40-yard line to the 41-yard line, and a first down for the Panthers. So we see the big play right after the interception and a fine run.
And Steve, you got to give credit to sophomore split in Jake Goheen, who threw a good block on the cornerback and gave Robert a chance to get to the corner and get past it and get the first down.
So the Panthers all of a sudden come to life. 8:30 to play in the first half, and Texarkana, they don't make lines on high school football games, but the Razorbacks on the road, it'd have to be something like a 10-point, 12-point favorite in this ball game. And right now, the Panthers going toe-to-toe. Scott Long, tight end, right side. Jumper gives right up the middle to Greg Little. Short yardage, maybe a gain of two, bring up a second and eighth situation. Greg Little, 180-pound sophomore. The yards, maybe not as important as just Greg getting the feel of the ball game. He's a sophomore. He's got to be a little nervous tonight, making his first varsity start, and so far he's handled the job well.
Steve, fullback runs in the bloodlines in that family. Last year, his brother Dennis was a starting fullback for the Panthers, but he was only like 150 pounds.
Second down, 8 yards to go. One receiver goes wide to the left side. Jumper down the line. He's got an opening. Turns it upfield. Watch out. 45, 40. It's a foot race. 35, 20, 15, 10. Look at Tommy go. He's knocked out at the 5.
And Steve, you got to give credit. We talked about Goheen making the block on the corner. That time, Monty Cornwell, the split in on the left side, picked off the safety and gave Tommy about an extra 35 yards.
Looked like a gain, maybe a 52 or 51 yards. It's down to the Texarkana 5. Tommy Jumper's longest run from scrimmage of the season. To this point, it was 24 yards, and they say Benton doesn't have speed, but Tommy held his own against the Greyhounds. First and goal to go. The crowd comes to life here at C.W. Lewis Stadium. Goheen wide to the right side. Option, watch out. Wide open and into the end zone is Robert McNeely. Oh, as Benton says hello to Texarkana, we've got a football game. Quickly to Bob Edmondson and what's got to be a rowdy sideline.
Steve, I don't know if you can hear me or not, but that 52-yard run by Jumper really brought this Benton Panther sideline to life. You can probably hear in the background, they're all over each other. Robert McNeely coming up with that little touchdown run, so look out, the Benton Panthers are back in it.
Four plays, 73 yards, all on the ground. And yes, Randy Russell drills the point after. We've got a football game. Conference opener. It's 7-7, 7:30 to play in the first half. Let's take a 1 minute break. Back at C.W. Lewis Stadium. Oh, what a drive. We haven't seen a drive like that in 1987. Four plays, 73 yards, all on the ground. Tommy Jumper Dwight Fite has really been defending Tommy Jumper. He knows the kid is a fine athlete, and he's been running for his life most of the season, Jeffrey, and it's really getting to show his stuff tonight.
He did, and that time he got to the only reason he was caught was pursuit angle.
McLean fields the kickoff. Now he's stuck and thrown down out across the 25 at the 26-yard line. Tony Hester, one-on-one tackle, a 180-pound sophomore. And that had to be a big play for big number 76 out there. He saw Charles McLean one-on-one and decided to wrap him up and throw him down at the mark at 28.
Another one of those sophomores, more and more of them. You know, Benton's got a chance to be in the conference race this year, and one thing that's good about it, they got a lot of sophomores and juniors who are contributing, so it looks like the program could be in good shape for the next two or three years.
Oh, I came to C.W. Lewis Stadium. Oh, I can smell upset in the air. Here we go. Gift goes right side to McLean. He's tripped up and covered by Shane Smith. It looked like Heath Nix with the initial hit. Called a gain of four as the ball gets across the 30 to the 32-yard line. Second down and 7 yards to go. The Texarkana offense has moved it on the Benton defense, but it's been a kind of a plodding along attack, not a typical Texarkana attack where they bust plays. And the longer Benton stays into the game, the more confidence the Panthers get and the better chance we have of an upset. Second down, 7 yards to go. The give goes right side to Dean. He breaks a few tackles, works his way for a first down, still going, bouncing off Panthers. Finally, Scott Long throws him down at the 48-yard line. Marcel Dean looked like Joe Morris. He was just fending off Panthers, and that was just a fantastic run by Marcel Dean. I emphasize Texarkana's backup tailback, who rushed last week for 172 yards.
Marcel Dean, it looks like when you hit him, instead of wrapping your arms around him, he kind of scoots back and you can't get a shot at him, and he keeps going. He has tremendous second effort.
The clock down to 6:10 to play in the first half. Razorbacks right to left. There goes the draw call to McLean. Hit the line of scrimmage by Heath Nix, and he's down. Bobby Van Cleave, the initial hit, and Heath Nix finished him. Something Benton hasn't done a good job tonight doing is finishing off the running back, and that time they did a good job on McLean. It'll be a second down, 7.5 yards to go. Can't emphasize how important it is to have sophomores that can go both ways like Nix and Mundy this early in their high school career and make big plays like that. I mean, they're up against some hosses tonight. Texarkana known for big linemen.
Texarkana's offensive line averaged 230 pounds, Steve.
And there goes another yellow flag thrown to the ground before the play, and it'll be an offside against Texarkana. And Bill Reed, he wears a hat, so I don't know how much hair he has under the hat, but if he's got any, he's going to start pulling it out.
Coach Reed, he wears a hat, but it's not exactly the same reason Coach Fite wears one. But he might be throwing that hat a little bit if these five-yard penalties continue.
Dwight Fite separates himself from the Panther team. He stands at the 32, looking across the field at the Texarkana offense, operating second and 13 at its own 46-yard line. The pitch near side of the field goes deep. Roger Parker, fine play, nails him at the line of scrimmage. Yes, another sophomore, but Roger Parker plays like a junior, 180 pounds, and he has just been steady this year.
And, Steve, every time there's a great play made, there's usually something that set it up. Craig Lincoln, the cornerback on the weak side, Texarkana pitched to the weak side, which was the wide side of the field. He kept pursuit, did not let Dean get outside, and Barker came across and made the tackle.
Third down, 12 yards to go. 7-7 ball game inside 5 minutes to play in the first half. Bet right even with Texarkana. Drew Legan goes wide right side, backs it an eye. Smith wants to throw. Here comes Scott Long. Smith will roll. He's going to tuck it under and run. He's close to a first down, but Scott Long kept pursuit, and along with Kirk Shelnut, came up with the tackle, and they stopped Smith shy of a first down. And there you see the importance of Scott Long's desire to play. A lot of linemen that go both ways would say, hey, the heck with it after I chase him in the backfield, but he ran Smith down. And another thing Dwight Fite likes to defend, Scott Long can run. He's playing with a bad turf toe.
He really is playing with a toe, which is something that's kind of been kept quiet, but he does a good job staying after the play.
And Texarkana in punt formation, jumper back deep. Plenty of time for the punter to get it off. Low line drive, jumper covers the football. Dangerous play, but he covered it nonetheless at the 15-yard line. Oh, man, he just smothered a line drive. And that could have been an awful big play. And it was. The fact that Tommy covered it inside 4 minutes to play in the first half. And I imagine right now, if we went to the locker room and went down to the field and told Dwight Fight, what do you think about going to the locker room now at 7-7, he'd say, that's just fine with me.
He would love it. But the thing is, Benton has to gain a couple of first downs here, or they will have to punt the ball away to Texarkana in good field position.
Last drive, four plays, 73 yards to even this ball game. Tommy Jumper, a big 52-yard run in that drive. Turn, the give goes up the middle, and forget it. Not much there. Those white shirts covered the Benton ball carrier before he got maybe a yard. Kirk Shelnut. So it'll be second down, 9 yards to go. The clock definitely a factor, closing in on 3 minutes to play in the first half. One first down, but almost assured Benton of running out the clock here in the first half. Tie ball game, Scott Long tight end right side, second and nine. Jumper gives straight up the middle. Not much there. Looked like Greg Little, the sophomore. Maybe a gain, short yardage, 2 yards. So it'll be third down and 7 yards to go. And it's back to basics for Dwight Fight right in this ball game at 7-7. Be interesting now to third and seven. You have a weapon like Scott Long, who is the best tight end and probably the best receiver in the state. And Texarkana knows that.
Texarkana, wherever Scott goes, they've got two guys lined up head up on him to try to hold him at the line of scrimmage.
Third down, 8 yards to go. Jumper gives a look to the right side. Now long count. Rolls back. He wants to throw. He's got plenty of time. Firing for Cornwell. It's going to be incomplete. Cornwell went to the ground. Benton fans wanted a flag, but the ball, in all likelihood, uncatchable. So it'll bring up a punt situation. But there you see Dwight Fight doing exactly what I think Jeff Reed was pointing to, going away from Scott Long to Monty Cornwell coming over the middle. And if the ball maybe was thrown off target, it would have been close. The Texarkana Razorback cut across, tried to make the interception, but it couldn't come up with it. So Long back at the three. Hermando Berry back at midfield. The snap is good. Here comes the pressure. Long will get it off. High, lazy kick. It's going to be fielded at the 47. Berry goes right side. He's nailed as he crosses midfield. Short return. Good job by the Benton kick coverage team, which had a rough go last week. And as I look to Aaron Windsor, a 180-pound junior, along with Rod Balding. But it's good to call these names like Windsor and Balding coming up on the special teams. Those are big plays when you're playing a team like Texarkana.
A lot of new names in there for Benton.
And Dwight Fight said he was going to concentrate on special teams this week, and it's obvious. And now Texarkana, with the clock running down in the first half, inside 2 minutes, goes to the shotgun. Smith gets the snap. He's in trouble. Rolling. Now fires downfield. A bullet incomplete. Craig Lincoln was all over Drew LeGrand for good coverage. And you see Smith is a great athlete, but the kid gets impatient. He's herky-jerky back there. He's going to run 1 second, throw the next, and honestly, I'd rather see him run than pass than run.
He has a very strong arm, but he's got good feet. Benton quickly noticed that Texarkana had switched to the shotgun there.
Split two receivers right, one to the left, one in the slot. Back to Smith. He's got plenty of time to throw. Fires! It's going to be incomplete, almost intercepted by Shane Smith, who really reacted to the football well. And Smith was there, but I think it was a case of Rod Smith humming it about 90 miles an hour over there, and maybe for Shane we might have lost him with a broken hand or something. It's third and 10.
It looked like kind of like a Roger Clemens or something. People come around here can relate to a Wes Gardner fastball zipping over there.
Shane's probably saying up there in the press box, looked like an interception. You get down here and catch that thing. Two receivers go to the right side, one to the left, still in the shotgun. Smith to fire deep down the middle. It's going to be tipped and incomplete. Once again, Monty Cornwell, fine defensive play, and Monty came to play tonight in the defensive backfield. Two big plays, and Benton says no to Texarkana on the clock, 1:41 to play, and Texarkana will have to go back into punt formation. And yes, the defense, they've been built up in the papers. I noticed both Little Rock papers saying how well the Benton defense has played, but believe me, this is the best game they've played in a while tonight.
They're playing a solid game.
Getting so excited, losing the voice here. It's 7-7. Inside 2 minutes to play in the first half. Punt formation. Benton will set up the return. Kick. Low. Tommy Jumper is going to field it. Loses the football. Texarkana covers it at the 11-yard line. And oh, that's just what Benton didn't need.
Steve, I want to point out something. It looked to me like Texarkana's punter went to a knee to catch that ball, and technically he should have been down there, it seemed like, but maybe the official felt like he got up before.
Bob Edmondson down on the sideline. Robert?
That's something I noticed. He was down on his knee to regain that ball. To me, I would think it he would be down there back up the arc.
We don't get any breaks. Here we go. Texarkana, first and 10. Tie ball game at the Benton 11-yard line. Smith fakes the pitch, turns it up inside, close to the 5-yard line. He'll be hit at the 6. Kelsey Deadman wraps him up, so it'll be second, and they can get a first down, so call it second and 4. First down is actually at the 2. The clock, 1:11 to play, 1:10. And this really could be a crippling blow to the Benton team confidence to play so well, and then that turnover could result in a 7-point lead for Texarkana at the half. Second down, 4 yards to go, Baxton and I. The gift to Marcel Dean, and he is just stacked up at the line of scrimmage. Dean did a little juking, but Greg Mundy and company were there to cover him up, and it'll bring up a 3rd and 4, and a timeout is called by the Texarkana Razorbacks. And Bill Reed will come onto the field, and we'll take a 30-second break. Your score, Texarkana 7, Benton 7. A big third down situation. It's 3rd and 3, Texarkana on the Benton 5-yard line. The defense really put in a tough position. They played so well in stopping Texarkana at midfield. And Tommy Jumper misplaying the Texarkana punt set Texarkana up at the 12-yard line. And the defense still holding tough. It's 3rd down, goal to go. And if Texarkana comes away with anything less than 7 points, victory for Benton.
You're right about that, Steve. Of course, you said goal to go, and I hate to correct you, but they can get a first down at the 2.
Yeah, 3rd down. Forgot about the marker. Is at the 2, and that could be big with the time remaining. Inside 50 seconds to go. Baxton and I. 5-man front, the pitch to Dean, running wide right side, he
Bumble.
Hits, there goes the football, and Benton's on it. Panthers take over at the 4-yard line. Big defensive play. And coming up with the football looked like it was Greg Mundy covering the football. So Greg Mundy with the big recovery, and there's a Benton Panther down on the field. Dan Cathy rushes out quickly to attend to the injured Panther, and I don't know if you noticed anything on that, Robert, down there on the sidelines. I know you got as long a look or a far away look as we have.
Now, Steve, really can't see. He's laying flat on his back with his head the other way. Well, a while ago you said something about we don't get the breaks, but that one certainly canceled out the questionable call a few minutes ago on that punt, didn't it?
Boy, big hit. I wasn't able to get the number of the Panther who made the big hit. Now Monty Cornwell is going to come off the field. It looks to be just a little dazed, but he looks fine, and that's good to see because Monty's played a strong first half. So 30 seconds to play in the first half, 7-7 ball game, and you can bet there'll be nothing fancy. I wouldn't be surprised to see Tommy Jumper take it right behind center Dwight Everett.
We'll probably see 3 quarterback sneaks here, Steve, or 3-2-1, whatever's necessary to run out the clock.
This could be Benton's night. Dwight Everett now maybe not sure with the count, turns around and has a few words with Tommy Jumper. Tommy, long count. Now he finally gets under center. Looks left, takes his time right up the middle. He'll squirt across the 5 to the 6. And the clock will wind down.
That'll be it, Steve.
10 seconds. They'll start it back up again. And boy, it'll be good to go to the locker room tied at 7. Been a long time.
Last time, Eddington, sports writer for the Arkansas Democrat, our special guest here at halftime at C.W. Lewis Stadium. Be back with the kickoff in 30 seconds.
C.W. Lewis Stadium, and happy 28th birthday to Greg Middlebrook, Saline County Electrical Supply. They sponsor, of course, our Most Valuable Player of the Game Award. Jeff Reed, several candidates for Benton tonight. Probably topping the list, a couple of big plays in that first half, not only by Tommy Jumper, but Monty Cornwell. He's had a big ball game.
Monty came to play on defense tonight, Steve.
I searched the press box trying to find out who made that hit on the fumble, and consensus is it might have been Monty Cornwell.
That gives him a big pass broken up, an interception, and a fumble. Steve, we're getting the second half ready here.
Jamie Jones at the four. Robert McNeely at the five. Rod Smith ready to get a foot into it. And here we go. Second half is underway. High end-over-end kick. Jones ranges over the sideline, bounces off his chest to the ground, picks it up at the 10. Crosses way across the field to the 15. Good move out across the 15 to the 16. And let's hear it for the sophomore. Had trouble handling the football, but regained his composure. Found a good little alley and worked it for 6 yards. Had to run about 20, but got his feet wet on the kickoff return. And not a bad job for Jamie Jones.
He showed some speed in the open field and some moves. If he can catch that ball next time and get a little more time, he may get a better return.
Here we go as we start the second half. Benton takes over at the 15. The backfield remains the same. Jumper, Little, McNeely, and looks like Lincoln gets the call at left halfback. Jumper options it, keeps. He's got good yardage. He's got the first down across the 25 to the 26-yard line. So Tommy Jumper for 11 yards, and Benton has a first down. And Tommy in the first half, 62 yards. That puts him up at 72 yards, 5 carries, and off to an outstanding start.
Like I mentioned at halftime, Steve, Coach Fite said all week they were going to run the option. They must have seen something against Arkadelphia against Texarkana that they like.
Let's give those Hosses on the left side credit. Tight end Scott Long. Over there, Kelsey Dedman and Heath Nix. Option the other way. Jumper's going to keep again. Nice run. He's across the 30 to the 34-yard line before he stopped for a gain of 7 and brings up a second and 2 yards. Good defensive play by Shelby Rayfield. So it's second down, 2 yards to go for Benton. Panthers operating left to right on your radio dial. Inside, 11 minutes to play. We're in the third quarter, 7-7 ball game. Texarkana got on the board first. The time running out in the first quarter, 8-yard run by Marcel Dean. Panthers came back the other way and get into the end zone. Robert McNeely doing the honors there. Second down, 2 yards to go for Panthers. Opening series, second half. Scott Long, tight end, right side. Cornwell wide to the left. Option left, jumper will keep. He has the first down as Tommy dives across the 40-yard line to the 42-yard line for a first down. So the Panthers quickly rack up 2 first downs to start the second half, and the ball is out in nice field position. Panthers out at the 42-yard line.
Steve, Tommy Jumper's got 89 yards on 7 carries now.
So Jumper, who came into the game second on the rushing charts, now moves into the team lead in rushing. Started the day with 260 yards on the year, well over 300 now. First and 10, Panthers, 7-7 ball game. Benton at its own 42, good running room. It's the sophomore Little across the 45 to the 46, and Greg Little bouncing off a few Texarkana Razorbacks for a nice game. Tony Guerra, I noticed, well into the line of scrimmage for a nice block, so call it second down and 4.5 for Benton.
Steve, that's the beauty of the triple option. You run outside 3 or 4 times, and it spreads that defense out, and there's the fullback for 5 and 6.
Once again, the offensive line doing a tremendous job. Second down, 4.5 yards to go. Jason McGee in the ball game. Wide to the right side. Now Jumper, I think he automatic to the line of scrimmage, wanted to throw, and now he's nailed in the backfield for a loss of 2, and that's exactly what Tommy Jumper did. He saw the defense, took the mouthpiece out, yelled over to Jason McGee to come over on the slant, and the play wasn't there, and Jumper ate the football.
Texarkana has a tendency to blitz at strong safety. When Benton sees that, they put in an audible where the split end will run a slant pattern. They just couldn't get the pass off.
So it'll be 3rd down, 7 yards to go. Panthers at their own 46-yard line. They need to get to the Texarkana 48-yard line. Jumper, options right side, turns it upfield. He's going to be close to a first down and reaches forward for a first down. Tommy Jumper, a fine effort, cut across the right side for a first down. Heath Nix, I notice, out there with another fine block. And they'll move the chains once more. 3 first downs to open the second half for Benton. And the folks that made the trip from Texarkana, nothing to cheer about early in the second half. We're now 8:30 to play in the third quarter. Benton has had the football for all this third quarter. First and 10, Panthers at the Texarkana 47, and now it's going to be Tony Guerra moving on the right side in motion against Benton. And Tony upset at himself there as he pounded his fist to the ground. And that is something Benton has not been guilty of much this year. I believe that's the first time that something like that's happened to Guerra, who's been in there for every play.
Tony's a very smart player who has good concentration, but the long snap count, he just got a little too anxious.
So it's first and 15 as the ball comes back to the Benton side of the field at the 47. Backs tight in the bone. Scott Long, tight end right side. Now jumper, options left. He'll turn up field, short yardage as he's hit as he crosses midfield and gets to the Texarkana 49-yard line. Good job by Lee Davis, a 233-pound senior, along with Fred Horton, another senior at 175 pounds. That brings up a second and 12 for the Panthers. And Monty Cornwell runs in with the play from Coach Dwight Fite. And Benton, Jeff, really in good field position if they want to try to throw the ball.
I'm kind of expecting to see a pass here, Steve. I think the situation calls for it. Of course, the option's there. They may option now. I think it might come toward us.
Second down, 12 yards to go. 7-7 ball game. We're midway through quarter number three. Jumper wants to throw. Screens it out. Lincoln makes a fine catch, but now falls to the ground for a loss of two. So that's one time. Craig probably went better off if he dropped the football, but that's easier said than done. When you're down there, you're just trying to make the play. And unfortunately, Craig showed good hands on that play, and it brings up a third and 15. It looked like initially on that play they might have been looking for Scott Long, but he was just...
Scott was tied up with two Razorbacks. They line up on top of him every time. This time he's only got one, so he may be able to get free.
Scott, 13 catches, 272 yards on the season. Jumper to throw. Here comes the pressure. He fires over the middle. It's going to be incomplete. He was looking for Scott Long. Fine defensive play made by Shelby Rayfield, a 153-pound junior. The pass was low. It would have been a tough catch, but Rayfield came diving across. It looked like he might have got a hand on the football. Brings up a punting situation, but the Panthers with those three first downs now put Scott Long in pretty good position as he stands at the Benton 31-yard line. Hermando Barry, he's dangerous. He stands at the Texarkana 19-yard line. Snap is high. It's over Scott's head. He corrals it. He's going to get the kickoff. It's a high kick. It's going to go out of bounds at the Texarkana 25-yard line. And Scott Long jumps into the air. That was as big a play as he's made all year. Rod Balding was high with the snap. It went over Long's head. He got a hand on it, regained the football, and somehow regained his composure. And now a bad spot of the football is going to put it at the 27-yard line. And it looks like they're going to have to restrain Perry Goodell over here at the sideline.
Steve, a good way to describe that play, for those of you who have seen Australian rules football on ESPN, Scott was on the run and kind of just kicked it on that. That's what it looked like to me.
That's something about Scott Long. He can help you in so many ways. So Texarkana, now confusion at the line of scrimmage as they take over. First and 10 at their own 27-yard line. Smith turns, running room, Charles McClain cuts across the 35. Still going at the 40, breaking tackles. He's finally thrown down by Randy Russell at the 46-yard line. So Charles McClain just kept those feet moving, and as a result, Texarkana in business and picks up an early first down, and they start out now at the 46-yard line. Fine run by Mr. McClain, who had 40 yards in the first half running in traffic.
They don't quit running when they're hit, do they, Steve?
Two fine backs, Charles McClain and Marcel Dean, set up in the eye. The give goes to Dean. Good yardage up the middle. Craig Lincoln finally with the stick along with Roger Barker, but not before Dean penetrated the Benton 42-yard line for a gain of eight. Brings up a second and 2.5 for the Texarkana Razorbacks. It's a big drive for Texarkana. They can stick it in here. Could really make things tough on Benton.
Big drive for the Benton defense. They got a good rest there to start the second half, and it looks like they need to get that blood pumping a little bit.
Drew LeGrand goes wide to the right side, and once again, here goes a penalty flag. And my guess is offside Texarkana. It's happened now maybe four times this game, and there's got to be one lineman who's doing it each time.
Well, the line judge is making the call the same time when they line up on the... Looks like they split or line up double tight ends to one side.
It turns a second and two into a second and 7.5, and Bill Reed, he's just got to be fit to be tied on that sideline across the way. Second down, 7.5, the ball back in Texarkana territory. The give to McClain, good job of Benton by stepping up the middle. Several Panthers, Kirk Shelnut, Bobby Van Cleve, Shelnut showing good agility. And it brings up a third down, 6 yards to go. They spot the ball at the Texarkana 49-yard line. Awful big play early in the second half. 5 minutes to play in the third quarter, and what a momentum builder right here.
Benton defense can show if it's serious about staying in this game or not right here.
The ball in the middle of the field. Smith, a little visit with his backs who are in an eye as he strides the line of scrimmage. Now he's under center, and they took too much time. Texarkana just not executing on offense tonight. If a team was ever primed for an upset, it's Texarkana. They have not played a smooth ball game offensively, and once again, we're in a third and 11 situation. And Texarkana has not had success throwing the football.
They have completed their first pass, but the last four have gone incomplete. Smith looks to get a little panicky when he gets pressure on him.
Yeah, he pushes that red button, and he's all over the place when that pressure comes. Let's see what they try. Third down, 11 yards to go. Smith turns. They set up the reverse. Here comes Barry. He's going to throw the ball. He's got a receiver wide open. The catch, and down the sidelines and out of bounds at the Benton 25-yard line. Bill Lawless from Hernando Barry on the reverse, and Hernando, I think maybe about 5'3 or 5'4. He's 5'3, made a heck of a pass, about 30 yards on a line, right to Lawless, and Texarkana comes up big.
Jason McGee was beaten on the play, or appeared to be. He was the safety on that, who saved the play for Benton.
And if your quarterbacks have trouble throwing, have your receiver throw. First and 10, the give to McLean. Fine defensive play made by Greg Mundy. Right at the line of scrimmage. Call it maybe even a loss of a half a yard. McLean, the up back, got the call. Mundy actually made penetration and had to reach back, and using his strength, he's only a sophomore, he pulled McLean down. So that brings up a second and 10, and the defense refuses just to give up.
Defense is playing well. The trick play got them there, burned, but they're showing they want to play tonight.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Hernando Barrow, wide left side. Smith to throw. He's got time. Over the middle, complete. It's going to be close to another Texarkana first down. It will be a first down. They'll spot the ball at the 11-yard line. Beautiful play fake by Smith. Then he delivered a bullet for the first down to Steve Dixon, a 176-pound senior. Smith appears to be all right when he has time. It's when you put the pressure on him that he panics. But set up well that time, made a nice fake, and hit his tight end over the middle. First and 10, Texarkana right to left on the Benton 12. Game tied at 7, inside 4 minutes to play, third quarter. Smith is going to keep it right side. He'll get to the 10, and that is it. Gain of 2, Bobby Van Cleve playing an active game from his linebacker spot. Scott Long also over there, so it'll be second down, 8 yards to go as they spot the ball at the 10. Once again, Texarkana in a position, if they don't come up with 7, it's really almost a victory for Benton. Second down, 8 yards to go. Ball on the right hash mark. Open side of the field is the left. Hernando Berry, wide to that side. Backs in an eye. Smith turns, wants to throw, fires over the middle. He's got a receiver spinning into the end zone for a touchdown is Steve Dixon. Big play, Rod Smith to Steve Dixon. And they've used their tight ends effectively tonight. And Smith, trouble throwing the ball in the first half, effective on that drive. And Texarkana is back in front 13-7. And Rod Smith will now attempt the point after. 3 minutes to play in the third quarter. Texarkana looking to make it 14-7. Smith's kick is up, and it's right down the middle. So Texarkana pulls in front 14-7, and we'll take a 30-second break. Okay, we're back at C.W. Lewis Stadium. Let's check in with Bob Edmondson. We'll let Robert call this kickoff. Go get him, Robert.
Okay, Steve. Well, they got another touchdown, but the Benton sideline is still up and still wanting to win. I want to say something about Craig Lincoln, number 42. Only practiced one day this week. He has mono, they believe, so he's out there fighting for the Panthers. Steve?
The kickoff, Jamie Jones works across the 25 to the 26-yard line. So that's where Benton will take over. As we move into the final minutes of the third quarter. Inside 3 minutes to play in the third quarter. Good tight ball game. Texarkana now back in front by a score of 14-7. And we'll see if the Benton offense can respond. Fine drive by Texarkana. Good passing by Rod Smith, the senior quarterback. Under center is Tommy Jumper. His backs Little, McNeely, and Shelnut. Option, right side of the field. The pitch to McNeely. Good running room up the sideline. Robert is knocked out of bounds at the 35-yard line. Close to a first down. It just depends on where the officials mark the football. And, yes, it looks like they're going to move the chains. They'll have to eye it across the field, take their time. And it's got to be a first down. Let's hope they don't bring the chains out this time. And now they move the chains. And a big play, and that's the fourth first down of the second half of the Benton offense. And moving the football on Texarkana. 2:30 to play in the third quarter. Benton operating, trailing 14-7. Quarterback sneak right up the middle goes Jumper. He's out across the 40-yard line for a gain of 4.5. Call it second and 5.5. Right behind Dwight Everett and Greg Mundy goes Tommy Jumper. And Jumper closing in on a 100-yard ball game.
Steve, that's his 11th carry, and he's now got 101 yards.
Just crossed it. Big game for Tommy Jumper, senior quarterback, trying to lead Benton to an upset of a top 10 team. Second down, call it 5.5 yards to go. The ball at the Benton 40-yard line. Panthers trailing 14-7. The give goes to Little. He's wrapped up at the line of scrimmage after a gain of one. Fine defensive play made in the inside of that defensive line by David Potter, shooting over from his defensive end spot one-on-one, and he just threw Greg Little down. So it'll bring up a 3rd and 4.5. The ball at the Benton 42-yard line. Panthers need to get to the 46 for a first down. Jake Goheen wide to the left side. Scott Long tight end right. Jumper options left side, turns it up. He'll have the first down as he crosses midfield into Texarkana territory at the 49-yard line. Tommy Jumper has made many big plays tonight, and that another. The good read on the option and the first down. And the Panthers are in Texarkana territory at the Razorback 48-yard line. The clock, 1:10 and counting. Third quarter, Razorbacks on top, 14-7. Conference opener for both teams. Jason McGee, wide to the right side. Jumper, options again, pitches, watch out, running room McNeely. Down close to the 40, now goes out of bounds at the Texarkana 38 for a first down. And Robert is not going to make any ballet classes or anything, but nice fancy little footwork on the sidelines for a first down. Wouldn't have had the first down if he didn't spin those feet.
He did a good job getting the extra yardage for the first down. McNeely, 6 carries, 46 yards.
Dwight Veit said, in essence, we're going to option them to death tonight. And some of his critics might have questioned the Benton head man, but that game plan has worked to perfection tonight. The offense has moved the football. Jumper, options left side. He's going to keep it. He's got good yardage. Turning it, now a fine defensive play made, running Tommy out of bounds at the Texarkana 34-yard line, and they hold it to a gain of 4 yards, potentially a big gainer, but Texarkana just did a fine job stringing that play out.
Steve, all these options are going to set up one time where Jumper's going to start the play fake to the fullback, he's going to drop back, and somebody's going to be open deep.
The ball at the Texarkana 34-yard line, and now a little confusion among the officials, and while they sort things out in the field, let's check in with Robert Edmondson, who's with a number one Panther fan.
That's right, Steve. You know, you have the top 10 in football. You have top 10s in football fans, and here's a guy that's top 10, Don Gatton, and he's a senior at Benton High School. And Don, you make all the games, don't you?
Yes, sir.
What do the Panthers need to do right now? Score?
Yeah, just about. Hopefully go for a long bomb.
Are you a senior this year, Don?
Yes, sir.
Listen, you're wearing a Panther jersey. Tell me about that.
Well, I don't know that much about the arrangement that Scott and the guys got with the coaches to get it. And everything.
Of course, Don is number 99 wearing a Panther jersey. Scott Long and all the teammates gave it to him. So Don's down there on the front, and I tell you what, he keeps an eye on the players, the officials, and everybody, and he's at all the football games. Back up to you, Steve.
Don's looking for the ball. Let's see what the Panthers try. Second and seven, the ball at the Texarkana 34-yard line. Scott Long, tight end, left side. Jumper Gibbs, right up the middle, short yardage for maybe 2.5 or 3 yards. Greg Little, the sophomore, it'll bring up a third and four as they spot the ball at the Texarkana 32. Benton has to get to the Razorback 48, Razorback 28 for a first down. And this definitely four down territory. Jason McGee, wide to the right side. Scott Long, tight end left. Jumper turns, options, cuts up. He has the first down. He's still going. Jumper inside the 20 to the 19-yard line. Tommy Jumper playing his best game of the year. He comes up limping just a bit. It's going to take, I think, a broken bone to get Tommy Jumper out of the ball game. He is a wiry.
Steve, Jumper, 14 carries, 125 yards.
Jumper, 125 yards. And now it's going to be timeout. It's going to be the end of the third quarter. We played three quarters. Your score, Texarkana 14, Benton 7. Let's take the one-minute break. The fourth quarter. Benton going right to left on your radio dial. First and 10 at the Texarkana 19, trailing the Razorbacks 14-7. Jake Goheen wide to the left side. Jumper turns the pitch. Shelnut's got running room. Across the 25, still going, puts his head down to the 12-yard line. Across the 15 to the 12 for a gain of 7. Brings up a second and 3. Hard running by Kirk Shelnut on the outside. And as a result, it's a 7-yard gain, and the Panthers continue to move the ball at will on this Texarkana defense.
Benton's offense has shown new life since the scoring drive in the first half, Steve.
Second down, 3 yards to go. Ball near side of the field on the Texarkana 12. Scott Long, always have to watch him. Tight end right side, jumper options right. Stutter steps, turns it in, inside the 5. Leans forward to the 2. Oh, fine effort by Tommy Jumper. He froze the Texarkana defenders with a little stutter step as he moved to the line of scrimmage, then cut it inside for a first down. It's a first and goal to go for Benton at the Texarkana 2. 14-7 Razorbacks lead. Plenty of time to go. 11 minutes to play in the ball game, and the Panthers just a couple of yards away from tying this one up. Monty Cornwell goes wide to the right side. Your backs left to right, McNeely, Little, and Shelnut. Tommy Jumper, long call, gives to Little. Across the right side, is he in? Jumper has his hands up. Yes, the official says. 14-13, a delayed call. I went with Tommy Jumper's signal. I figure the kid's been, he isn't gonna lie at this point on first down, but he put those hands up a good, maybe 2 seconds before the official.
And that help, I saw Scott Long's hands go up too, Steve.
Big point after. Randy Russell was good on his first attempt. It's 14-13. Tommy Cody will have the hold. Greg Little, sophomore, making his first start, big touchdown. Snap is good. The kick, a line drive is in. Yes. 14-14. What a ball game. We'll take a 1 minute break. Get you all tied up.
For the Razorbacks.
into the kick. Long driving kick. Armando Barry across the 20. 25 makes a juke to the 30, and he's nailed there. Good job by the kick coverage team of hemming in Armando Barry. If you're going to listen to the Razorback game tomorrow, there's a guy on Texas Tech by the name of Tyrone Thurman. He's the smallest man in college football at 5'3". It's a simulation of Armando Barry, who's 5'3", 129, but Armando can move. He's got a fast name. 14-14. What a ball game. 11 minutes to play. Texarkana first and 10 at their own 30-yard line. The give to McLean. He weaves his crazy way across the 34 to the 35. Bobby Van Cleve. Randy Russell playing like a madman at his defensive end spot came diving across to help on the hit. Call it a gain of 4. Going to spot the ball at the 35. Second and 6 from the 35 for the Razorbacks. This is the real season. Officials timeout. Now they're going to get back at it. Benton 2-3 in the non-conference, but you can wipe that out. These are the games that count. Second down, 6 yards to go. The pitch to Marcel Dean, running left, hit at the line of scrimmage and thrown down. Roger Barker, Bobby Van Cleve.
Bobby Van Cleve and Roger Barker.
And Bobby Van Cleve is just moving so well from his linebacker spot. He is just playing a heck of a game all over the field, left and right, and a big 3rd and 5 for Texarkana, Jeff. And the way Smith has been throwing the ball, it's really a question of what they're going
to
do.
I think they'll either pitch it to the tailback and run to the wide side towards the press box, or they'll hit one of those tight ends.
High set behind quarterback Smith, 3rd and 4. He turns, gives, left side to McLean. He's going to be close to a first down. It's going to be awful tight. Depends on where they mark the football. Almost a counter play. Craig Lincoln made a fine open field tackle. And they're going to measure. And this is a big measurement. It's all the way across the field. They stretch out the chains. First down, Razorbacks. They opted to go with almost a counter move. They made it look like a sweep right. At the last second, they gave to McLean. And he went by himself to the left side and made a few good moves, as he's done all night. As a result, they have a first down. Razorbacks at their own 41-yard line, 14-14 game, inside 9 minutes to go. Smith turns, gives to McLean, stumbles forward. Now he's nailed after a gain of 2. Football flies out of bounds, but after the whistle, Craig Lincoln, Bobby Van Cleve, Roger Barker, 2nd down, 8 yards to go. And if we've ever had a team effort on defense, it's tonight. I've called, I think, every name on that defense tonight.
There are a lot of different Panthers who are wearing those maroon jerseys on the defensive side of the field they're fired up.
Keith Nix comes off and gets a good hand from his teammates into the ball game. Kelsey Dedman, 2nd down, 8 yards to go. Texarkana on its own 43-yard line. Smith turns, fires over the middle. He's got a man. Watch out. In Benton territory, down the sidelines, 30, 25, 21-yard line. Now he slides inside to the 17 before Jason McGee can come up with the hit. And once again, it was his tight end, Bill Lawless. Credit Rod Smith with a major league play fake. He froze the Benton secondary, froze this announcer for just a second, and then delivered a bullet over the middle. Fine pass, fine catch, beautiful execution, and Texarkana is in business, 1st and 10 at the Benton 17-yard line. The Benton pep squad, BAMM, comes to its feet right under us. Smith turns, gives right side. McLean's got running room. Inside the 10, knocked out of bounds there. Another first down for Texarkana. Credit Charles McLean with a nice job of running. And Texarkana is 1st and goal to go at the Benton 9-yard line. The clock a factor, 7:40 to play. And the defense under the gun at this point.
Steve, this is a good position you want Texarkana to be in. If they're going to have 1st and goal, make it be 1st and goal at the 9.
1st and goal to go. The ball at the Panther 9-yard line. 14-14 ball game. Texarkana looking to push in front. Drew LeGrand, wide right side, backs in an eye. Dean over the right side. He'll fly forward to the five for a gain of four. Kelsey Dedman, Greg Mundy, second down. Goal to go, the ball at the Benton four-yard line. Hernando Barry comes in with the play from Coach Bill Reed. Wouldn't be surprised to see Texarkana try that same player, that sweep left that scored with Marcel Dean in the first quarter. Tight end left side, Bill Lawless has a fine ball game going. Pitch goes to Dean, left side. He's going to try to run for the corner and get in. Fine effort. Roger Barker looked like he had Dean at the three, but as he had several times tonight, Dean kept the feet pumping and worked his way in for six. And Texarkana back on top as we go back and forth, 20-14. And now Rod Smith, quarterback, kicker, puts his shoe on, his kicking shoe, and will try to get in position for a crucial point after the way this game is going. Could be the last team with the football wins. Here we go. Snap, hold is good, kick is high enough, and right through the middle. 21-14, Texarkana forges back out in front. Let's take a 30-second break and be back to C.W. Lewis Stadium. Give the Texarkana Razorbacks credit. Excellent drive, 8 plays, 69 yards, Jeff Reed. And once again, the Benton offense will be called upon to fire back.
But for the first time in 3 weeks, the offense has the confidence to move the football.
An even 7:05 to play in this ball game. Smith's kick, high, short. It's going to bounce. Now McNeely will pick it up at the 10, across the 20. To the 23-yard line. Hard to see exactly, to point out exact yard lines with all the yard line markers strewn across the sidelines. So Benton 77 yards away from tying this football game up. Just over 7 minutes to play in this ball game. 4A South opener, 21-14. This has just been, Jeff, a tremendous ball game.
It's a real confidence builder for the Panthers, who have been struggling in weeks, as everyone knows.
Panthers right to left on your radio dial. Down by 7, first and 10. On their own 23, jumper options right. He's got running room. Across the 30 to the 31-yard line, Tommy Jumper well over 100 on his way to 150 yards rushing on the night. But knowing Tommy Jumper, that's the last thing on his mind, rushing numbers. The only numbers he's concerned with are on the scoreboard. 21-14, Texarkana. 6:40 to go in the game. Second down, 3 yards to go. The ball across the Benton 30 at the 31. Jumper gives up the middle, running room for Greg Little. The sophomores out across the 35 to the 37 for a first down. And Greg Little, no longer a sophomore. He's already run for a touchdown and has handled the ball very comfortably at fullback. And Dwight Fite, not a bit afraid to call him a sophomore tonight.
Little has 28 yards on that carry.
Not bad, first time out. First and 10 for Benton on the 37. 6:15 to go in the ball game. Texarkana, a tenuous 7-point lead. Jumper options, keeps. Takes a couple of hits as he works for short yardage. Tommy slow to get to his feet. After a gain of maybe 2. So it'll be second down, 8 yards to go. And Tommy Jumper, a lot of yards on the evening. But as we saw on that play, he's really taking a beating to get those yards.
Tommy has 145 yards now, 17 carries.
Jake Goheen, wide to the right side. Ball across the Benton 40 at the 41. Second down, 7 yards to go. Scott Long, tight end left side. Jumper, turns, options right. Turns it upfield across the 45 to the 46. And he's asking Mr. Referee to grab my face mask. And he had a legitimate gripe.
I saw his head sling back there, and I was wondering if that was going to be the call.
But he's smart enough, when he realizes the officials missed it, not to sit there pleading his case, but to think about a third and three situation. The call is in from Coach Dwight Fite, and with the time remaining, closing in on 5 minutes to play, this may be fourth down territory for Benton. The ball out across the 45-yard line. Third down, 2 yards to go. jumper, quarterback sneak, he has the first down. Across midfield to the Texarkana 49-yard line. Right behind Dwight Everett for the first down.
Eric Garden on the last time.
Inside 5 minutes to play. Your margin, 7 points. Texarkana Razorbacks holding the lead, but Benton on the move as they join hands in the huddle. Now they break. Cornwell goes wide to the right side. Scott Long, tight end, left side. Jumper slow to get under center. Now they're set to go. Jumper turns, option right side. He's got running room, another 4 yards before he's stuck and stuck good. At the Texarkana 46-yard line, Tommy really took a lick. Once again, he's the last man to get up as he goes over 150 yards. What a ball game for Tommy Jumper. Second and six. And if things go at this pace, Benton could be operating close to the Texarkana goal line with seconds remaining. Second and seven. The ball at the Texarkana 46. Jumper turns, options left. He's going to be hit short yardage, maybe a gain of one. Good job by the Texarkana defense. A fired up Texarkana defense finally stopping Tommy Jumper. Fine defensive play for Texarkana on that play by Bill Lawless, who's had a big game at tight end. Lawless, a couple of big catches tonight. So it's third down, 6 yards to go. The ball to Texarkana 45. For a first down, Benton needs to get to the Razorback 39-yard line. Jumper turns, options right side, turns it up, dives forward. He is close to a first down. Looks to be just about even with the marker. It all depends on where they mark the football. Kirk Shelnut says, forget the chains. It's a first down, but let's see. The officials eye it. Now they bring the chains out.
Steve, no doubt if they're short, you know they're going for it here.
Oh, Tommy Jumper laid it all on the line. Scott Long says, move the chains, as he fires his right fist into the air. And the crowd erupts. Another Panther first down.
Steve, the jumper numbers continue to roll. 22 carries, 164 yards.
He put his body on the line for that first down. He saw a marker and laid it out. And it paid off. Tommy now with a slight limp as he comes to the line of scrimmage. Monty Cornwell, wide right side. The backs remain in the bone behind a Benton offensive line that's been doing the job. Jumper wants to throw. He's got time. He's looking for Long. Scott's open. He makes a great catch at the Texarkana 13. That's why Scott Long is being so heavily recruited. And Tommy Jumper made an off-balance throw across the field, took a shot, and that ball was right on target. Great catch by Scott Long. First down, Benton.
Steve, the triple option, which Benton had run 8 straight times to one side or the other. Then they start the option. They fake to the fullback. Tommy bounces back in the behind the line, throws it up in the air. Long makes a big catch. Hey, we're in good position now.
They had two people out there on Scott Long. But one against two in this case, the advantage goes to Benton. Scott Long, he doesn't have the big numbers tonight, but remember back early in the ball game, the bad snap? Who saved us there? Scott Long. Who comes up with the big catch tonight? Scott Long. He'll get you sooner or later, one way or another. And on to the field. We check in with Bob Edmondson, what's got to be a pumped up Benton sideline.
Steve and Jeff, you would think this was the state championship, the way the coaches and the sideline and even the crowd here reacting here to the Panthers' drive that could tie things up. And Jason Blank, number 9, boy, he is really a cheerleader. He's been running up down the sidelines and getting the band up and the fans, and they are definitely in the ball game, the fans and the players.
2:50 to play in the game. First and 10, Benton at the 14. Greg Little, feet churning, short yardage right up the middle for a gain of 2. They'll spot the ball at the 12. It'll be second and 8. Benton. And this, my friends, is the ball game. 2:31 clock on the move. 21-14 Texarkana. The offense has had its best game of the year. Monty Cornwell, wide to the right side. Scott Long with two Texarkana Razorbacks in his face, tight end left. Now jumper turns and falls on the option. No gain, it'll be third and nine. Maybe called a loss of one.
Steve, Tommy and Greg Little, the fullback, got mixed up on the exchange there. Looks like Greg wanted the ball and didn't quite let go, and Tommy pulled it out and he tripped over Greg's back feet as Greg was running through the hole. So it puts us in a bind. But we got an injured Razorback down.
Texarkana Razorback on the field. And both the Benton staff and Texarkana coach Bill Reed out. And why they attend to that injured Razorback, let's take a timeout. Once again, the situation, just over 2 minutes to play. When we come back, Benton will have a big third and nine at the Texarkana 13. Let's take a quick 30-second break. Tight end left side. Jason McGee wide to the right. Now the Benton pep steppers and bam, really come to life. Third and nine. The snap, jumper, options right, fakes the pitch, turns it in. He's going to be close to a first down, about a yard shy as he's hammered to the ground at the six. For a first down, Benton needs to get just inside the Texarkana five. So the Panthers are facing a fourth and a little over a yard. And with under 2 minutes to go, this is the ball game.
This is what we've all waited for.
You can hear the crowd yelling, go, go, go. And now timeout is called on the field by the Razorback defense. A little personnel change. And the Benton coaches, Dwight Fite, makes his way out to confer with the offensive team. The other coaches pacing the sidelines. What a ball game. Who would have thought? Coming down to a fourth and one and a half. The ball at the Texarkana, just outside the five, maybe the five and a quarter, with a minute 30 to go, 21 to 14. I'm already thinking about the point after. I have confidence in this offense.
I'm thinking about the overtime, Steve. Of course, it's a conference game. It ends in a tie. We're going to line it up on the 10, and each team gets four plays to see what they can do with, and that's the overtime rule in Arkansas. I've yet to see a overtime game in about 10 years of covering high school football.
And I saw one when I was over in Fort Smith north side and south side for a state playoff spot, and it was exciting. I think Northside stuck it in on third down, and Southside came back, worked it to the one. And that's like a Benton-Bryant rivalry, and didn't stick it in the end zone. Dwight Fite is still out there talking with Tommy Jumper. And lately on offense, the Jumper has said, I'm going to take care of it, guys. He's faking the pitch, but he's holding on to the football. Fourth and a yard and a half. The Benton players on the sidelines now urging the crowd to come to its feet. Just outside the five. Fourth and a yard and a half. Jumper turns around the right side. He leads forward. He'll have the first down. Tommy Jumper.
First down, Panther.
Listen to the crowd. I can't say enough about the offensive line or Tommy Jumper. He is simply putting his body on the line. First and goal to go at the three.
Jumper's numbers, 25 carries, 174 yards.
There's a couple of big ones left. First and goal to go. Benton right to left on the Texarkana three, trailing by seven. Jumper, options right. He's going to keep. He's in the end zone. It's a one-point ball game. Tommy Jumper went in standing up, 21-20. And now, timeout is going to be called on the field by Ben. And Dwight Fite has a decision to make. As effective as his offense has been, and now he says, I'll play for overtime. He has confidence in Randy Russell, who's 2 for 2 tonight. And Randy's back on the field. Look back to the beginning of the year. If Russell hits this, I wouldn't have thought in the first three games that any Benton kicker would have a chance to be 3 for 3 on point afters.
Well, Steve, we made the last one against Catholic. This, we're going for four in a row as a team.
Tommy Cody will spot the ball. The senior backup quarterback will have the hole. Russell's kick is up. Yes, we're tied. Oh, Randy Russell. What an addition to the team. It's 21-21. And we have got one heck of a ball game going down to the sidelines. Maybe you can talk with one of those pep steppers who have worked their way onto the Benton sidelines. They've come out of the stands, Bob Edmondson.
Having a hard time hearing you down here, Steve, amongst everybody. It's very loud, but we've got a minute and 10 seconds left. Pep steppers behind me. Oh, they're really loud. And looks like we might see a little overtime coming up here in a few minutes, but we've got to remember Texarkana is an explosive ball team, and anything could happen on this kickoff.
What a ball game. 1 minute, 10 seconds to play, 21 all. Hey, let's hear it for Dwight Fite and his coaching staff. They have really prepared their Panthers to play a football game. Don Fulcher, Perry Goodell, Danny Jordan, Les Davis, Jack Roseberry. Guys that haven't lost faith in this team, despite losing three in a row. Oh, the adrenaline has got to be pumping inside Randy Russell as he gets ready to put a foot into the football. Here we go. Russell's kick, low line drive, squib. It's going to bounce at the 20. It's fielded there by Lawless across the 30. 35-yard line and rammed out of bounds there. Texarkana will have an even minute to operate. Just had a feeling, walked in here tonight, that these Benton Panthers were going to rise to the challenge. Win or lose, you can be proud of your Benton Panthers. First and 10, Texarkana at the 36-yard line. We're all tied at 21. The backs now split. We go in a shotgun, two receivers wide. Now Smith to throw over the middle. It's going to be complete at midfield. Lawless works his way across midfield to the Benton 44-yard line. 50 seconds to go in the game, and Texarkana threatening to win this in regulation. Smith, the kicker, on point after, has really shown a fine leg, fine strong leg. Once again, Razorbacks stay in the shotgun. Two receivers left, one right. Smith back to throw. Here comes the rush. Fires, incomplete. Good job by Shane Smith. If that football is on target, Shane Smith has a shot at an interception.
And if he intercepts it, Steve, he's probably going to be in the end zone celebrating in about 10 seconds.
Second down, 10.
Substitutions. Heath Nix, Robert McNeely in. Greg Mundy, Jason McGee out. Shotgun formation for Texarkana. 41 seconds to play in the ball game. Texarkana second and 10 in Benton territory. Smith the throw. Plenty of time. Fires wide open. Lawless down to the Benton 26.
Lawless complete.
And now timeout called by Texarkana.
First down, Razorbacks.
37 seconds to go. Razorbacks on the Panther 26-yard line. Bill Reed.
From the Panther 27.
No tie. At this time, he ripped that tie off long ago. Don Fulcher out to talk to his defense, saying, come on, guys, the offense has come through for you here in the second half. Let's suck it up and stop these guys and bring it to overtime.
Steve, you got to give credit to the Texarkana line. We talked about if you can put a little pressure on Rod Smith, he seems to kind of push the panic button really quickly. And they're giving him a lot of time to throw the ball. Benton's rushing four to five guys, and they cannot get near him.
The time, plenty of time. 37 seconds to go. 21 all. Texarkana on the Benton 27-yard line. Rod Smith, after a slow start, has really heated up. And Bill Lawless has done a good job catching Smith's bullets. They're about knocking him down. We're ready to go. Don Fulcher off the field. Bill Reed off the field. Once again, the Razorbacks stay in the shotgun. Panthers show a five-man defensive front. Here comes the blitz. Smith rolls right, fires. He's got a man complete at the Benton 17-yard line. Hermando Berry. Randy Russell, Craig Lincoln, Robert McNeely. All over there, but not before Barry the football. So with 21 seconds to go, Texarkana continues the drive, and yes, they are in field goal position, but they stay in the shotgun formation. And now they're going to call for a measurement. The looked like he had the first down, but the chains are all the way across the field, and now they bring him across. 21 seconds to go. Texarkana, a masterful job working the clock. Now they stretch the chains out.
First down
by a good foot and a half. And I don't know who that official's timeout benefited. Maybe the Benton defense at this point with a lineman got a chance to load up. Really surprised that Texarkana is staying in the shotgun at the Benton 17. Wouldn't be surprised to see a quick give. Now Smith back to throw. Here comes the rush. Scott Long almost gets to him. Smith fires. He's got a man inside the five. It's slammed to the ground by Robert McNeely. At the four is Bill Lawless, who has had a game.
Timeout, Razorback.
So with 20 seconds to go in the ball game, Texarkana in great position to win this football game in regulation. Can't say enough about the job Rod Smith did. Scott Long was putting on some serious heat. Smith kept his composure and then delivered a bullet to Lawless.
Looks like the best Benton can hope for here, Steve, would be a fumble. I don't think the Razorbacks will risk throwing another pass with 21 seconds left. They'll probably run something to the tailback or the fullback, coming to the right side, trying to get it in the middle of the field, and then we'll have Smith kicking what would appear to be just like an extra point.
Kelsey Dedman come into the ball game. Shotgun formation, you have to get a good snap, and you have to get protection. And Smith has gotten both and really thrown the ball well on this drive. They will stay in the shotgun. The shotgun itself, just the snap back from center, a dangerous play. Smith having trouble.
Steve, we could watch a trick. Excuse me, they could watch a trick, but they may. Nope, never mind.
Smith the throw. Rolling. Fires. Incomplete. He had a man in the end zone and underthrew Bill Lawless. And Rod Smith knew he had Lawless open and just fired a fist into the air like, I blew it. I had a shot. Now the clock, it's impossible to see from our vantage point.
18 seconds.
18 seconds, got a utility pole, light pole right in the way. The snap back to Smith, rolls, the pressure's on, loops it, touchdown Texarkana. Steve Dixon in traffic. Oh, give credit to Texarkana. They didn't play for a field goal. They played for a touchdown. And the closer you get to the goal line, the harder it is to execute pass plays. They did it. And as a result, with 13 seconds to go, Rod Smith is attempting the point after. Smith's kick is up, and it is good. 28-21. Benton in need of a miracle. 13 seconds to go. Let's take a 30-second timeout. Stadium. Texarkana 28, Benton 21. 13 seconds remaining in the football game.
Rod Smith to kick off for the Razorbacks.
A fine effort.
Jamie Jones and Robert.
But it looks like Benton is going to come away with a loss despite a tremendous effort.
Been the best effort by the Panthers probably this season, Steve.
Texarkana, Rod Smith, who's had an unbelievable second half, now set to kick off. Jamie Jones stands at the five. Robert McNeely flanking Jones. Now Smith ready to approach the football. He kicks deep, line drive. Can be fielded by one of the short men, Scott Long, borrowing across the 30 to the 34. And I mean, it took a, and we're gonna have a penalty flag. It's one Texarkana Razorback all over Scott Long while he was on the ground.
And Steve, we may have two penalties there because one referee threw it and then another one threw it. So I don't know if they'll call one or two on there.
5 seconds to play. I'll tell you exactly what happened. Texarkana got frustrated because they couldn't bring Scott Long down. So they team tackled him. Personal foul, Texarkana. Just one. They deserve about three. There's about three people jumping all over Scott on the ground. And Benton may have chance for a Hail Mary as the football comes out to midfield. 5 seconds to play. This has been a strange game.
9 seconds
to play as I try to look across right and the light pole is right in the way. Have to have Coach Goodell move it for next week's ball game. 28-21. Ball at midfield. Benton trailing by 7. One receiver far side of the field, and now the officials call timeout. Now I wonder on a play like that, Jeff, if there was ever cause, those flags were thrown at separate times.
They really were, Steve. I thought so. One guy threw it, and then the Texarkana guy stayed on top of Scott, and then another official threw his.
I think it was just a case of frustration. They attempted to tackle him. About 7 Texarkana Razorbacks.
Steve, they may be thinking about resetting the clock.
Ball, first and goal.
That was an awful long.
Apparently not.
First down, the tip of the ball. Just shy of midfield. One receiver far side of the field. Jumper, the reverse to long.
He's
Scott
open.
Wants to throw. He's got a man, Cornwell. Let's see if he can get it there. No, it's incomplete. Monty Cornwell had his man beat down the right sideline, and that is the ball game. Scott Long struggles to his feet.
Remember now, stay with us for the tenth ever performance.
And is congratulated by Bill Reed.
Immediately right after the ball game.
And a few Texarkana Razorbacks, and that was the call. Monty Cornwell was open. Scott Long, it's a tough throw. Stop and pop and try to throw it 50 yards.
Scott has the strongest arm on the team, and Coach Fight is laughing. They said he could probably play quarterback if we had to. And they tried the end around and him throw it long to Cornwell. On the run, he couldn't quite get enough. Monty had his man deep, beat deep.
28-21. Texarkana Razorbacks, let's take a 2-minute break and we'll be back to wrap it up.
Vote for your Tiger.
There are also Tigers in Toulon.
Toussaint?
I don't like the Toussaints of this world any more than you do. And I certainly don't like threatening a man into doing things, but...
You don't give me much choice. Prison in England, guillotine in Toulon. I'll take the guillotine. It's quicker.
Look, I need your vote. I've got an order here to requisition her. And if necessary, I'll be the Thai goat. On my own.
Lieutenant.
Tell me, that old man, Perrault, every time I look at you, he seems to be... Is he jealous?
Why should he be? He's my best friend. He's done everything for me. He wants me only to be happy.
And so do I.
Carries a ton and a half of ballast.
How does she take the wind?
Like a bird.
Yes, well. Seems sound enough. What speed she make?
7 knots with a good wind.
Mm-hmm.
9 with a good sailor. Oh, excuse me.
And you're a very good sailor.
Yes. Too good to let myself be caught by the English.
But if you're with me when they catch us, they could believe it.
You think they're going to swallow your story? You know what they would say? 2 men in a small boat? Not enough provisions? Carrying important dispatches all the way? Impossible.
Yes. Impossible on my own.
See you run a line from mainsail to rudder.
I always figured I would take her out alone.
Sensitive to rudder?
Depends upon the hand.
Well, I want yours.
You'll have to do without it.
You mean after all the work you've done on this boat, you're going to just hand it over to me?
You've left me no choice.
Vera! But one man alone, he can't handle that boat.
It all depends. I can.
Never mind, my dear. I can't be going very far.
You don't expect to go very far.
No, not in our boat, but in another one, possibly.
Alette, what's the matter with you?
I would never see him again. He's going away, I'm dead.
Is it something you said to her?
It was something I didn't say.
Following the rover, Cary Grant's looking for love in the strangest places, and he's delightfully funny in his last film, Walk, Don't Run. Next.
Bob, I need a trainer.
How about Eddie?
He's just a kid.
So was I.
You've worked long and hard to get there. When the time comes, you hope you're ready. With age for that clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
This buzz for you.
This shine can't be beat. You can't get a brighter shine. You can't get a tougher shine. And you can't get a better shine from Future or Bright. This shine only comes from Mop and Glow. Even on no-wax floors, you can't get a brighter, tougher shine than Mop and Glow.
I don't clean anymore. Because none of these ordinary cleaners gives me what I want. Now I clean and disinfect with Lysol deodorizing cleaner. Look, Lysol not only cleans the greasiest dirt, it disinfects. Lemon Fresh Lysol cleaner takes cleaning one step further.
There are two ways to get rid of cigar odor. Get rid of the cigar or use Lysol spray. Get rid of the fishy odor or use Lysol. Ordinary air fresheners just cover odors. Lysol kills germs on surfaces, cleans the air. So relax, enjoy. Lysol spray actually cleans the air.
My son, little sugar sweetened Kool-Aid. Some picture, huh? always striving to be better. Well, the other day he says, great news, Mom. Now I have 10% less sugar. What a good boy. 10% less sugar. Plus, he tastes great, so the kids adore him. Oh, I feel so good. Oh, wouldn't any mother?
New sugar-sweetened Kool-Aid drink mix. 10% less sugar with more fruity flavor for that great Kool-Aid taste.
Oh! Mom, I'm home.
If only he'd learned to use the door.
How far do your kids have to go when they need information in a hurry?
I better get to the library before it closes.
If he only had the new Encyclopedia Britannica at home, he wouldn't have to go through all this. He could be learning right now about science, art, medicine. A two-volume index makes subjects easy to find, and thousands of illustrations bring them to life. The new Encyclopedia Britannica, it's your key to the information age. But they can't use it if they can't get to it. Call this toll-free number for a free booklet on Britannica. Plus, receive your first copy of Britannica World Data Annual. It's free from Britannica Home Library Service when you acquire Britannica. Preview Britannica and receive free this three-volume desk reference set. Call 1-800-257-1234 for your free booklet and details on how you can receive your desk reference set. Encyclopedia Britannica, the library that never closes.
No one could be lonelier than the victim of child abuse, with nowhere to turn and no one to explain why. The anguish can last a lifetime, which is why the victims of child abuse so often become child abusers. If you know of child abuse, please report it. If you are a child abuser, please end the tragic cycle by seeking help now. A public service message from this station and the New York State Bar Association.
Simon, check on that boat.
Aye, aye, sir.
You go up to that house.
Aye, aye, sir.
British Corvette, right? Answer.
I don't have to tell you anything.
And I don't have to let you live. We'll start again. You are from the Corvette.
Yes.
What is that landing party doing here?
To go up to the farm to get fresh food, meat. The cold's breaking out in scurvy.
I don't believe your story.
What's the matter?
Through the window, we could see a uniform coat. French officer.
Right. We'll try further down the coast. Come on.
Aye, sir.
You keep your voice down and give me the truth.
I am telling you the truth.
You were scouting this boat.
No. Why would my captain be interested in just another tartan?
Your captain knows about this boat.
No.
Shh. But now you do. Your friends.
There's no time for that. Get in. The French officer up there. He may have troops around. Shove off.
What are you doing up so late?
Oh, it's hot.
Yes, it is, isn't it? Excuse me, I must speak to the lieutenant.
He's not in.
Oh, where could he... are you sure?
Yes, his door is still open. You could leave word with me.
No, no, it's important. I see him. I'll wait.
With each other?
Of course, Miss Cat.
Arlette, what can she mean to you?
I don't know. A new life for me. A chance for the life I never had. You see, I had to grow up too fast. I was a boy, and there's a whole piece of my life that's missing. All the years that belong to a young man.
Oh, Perol, you can't take the years and put them away in a chest to use later. You're no longer a young man.
Yes, I know. But I still have a few years left. Anyway, 1 year can be a lifetime. I still have a lot to give. In love, understanding. And Arlette will be richer for the years I didn't spend. She's with him, isn't she? Why didn't you tell me? Why?
What did you expect? I tried to tell you. I didn't want you to get hurt. But you can't see. You don't see. You refused to see that I... Pedro, you said another kind of life for you.
Yes, I know.
And yes, maybe another kind of life for... Perol, you can stay. You can stay.
Thank you, Catherine. Thank you. God, I've been so blind. You deserve something better than a wounded old fool.
Are you all right?
I'm fine. must have fallen fast asleep. All right, let's get my gear.
Must I waste it?
It's Catherine.
She knows I love you.
I love you too.
I know you love me.
But I have to go. It's first light, I told you.
But you can't go. If you love me, you wouldn't go. You have to stay with me for always.
You don't understand. I have to go.
You changed your mind.
Yes, I've changed my mind.
You're coming with me?
I said I changed my mind.
I told you, this boat is in the service of the Republic. Now, come off there. Come on. Michelle, cast off the bow line. I'll take her out myself.
Critical line crew. Going to be taken by one of the up men at the ball on the Panther 42-yard line. Wide receiver towards us. Make up the middle pitch out, right side to the tailback, number 44. He's down to the 45.
Yeah, the ball.
And
we got it.
Back. Long count. Takes the ball. Hands off. Corey Hill over right tackle. Back to the 50, 45. And down inside the 40.
Now he carried that ball five.
To the right. Long to the left as a tight end. Wishbone. Jump to the quarterback, takes the ball, takes up the middle. No, he gives up, pitch out left side to Sam Carson. We'll get it right in a minute. And Carson's down to about the 14.
Yes, sir, he's got a...
The back hands off to the left. Halfback and good. Roll about
that play.
Number 22, Lamar. Two tight ends in the wishbone. Williams, the quarterback. Out the middle. No, he's going to keep it. Passes the ball. Way down. It's going to be intercepted by Tony Wright on the 40, 35, 30, 25, 20, 15.
Hey, now.
Wishbone formation. First down and 10 from the Malvern 14-yard line. Benton Panthers have it on the interception. Little play across the middle.
Sophisticated intelligence tools help keep the peace in a dangerous world. Spy machines. That's next time on Nova.
On ATN, tomorrow night at 7 o'clock. In November of 1943, a little-known island in the Central Pacific was the site of some of the worst carnage of World War II. For nearly 4 days, men of the 2nd Marine Division and Imperial Japanese forces fought over a tiny coral atoll called Toro.
Last platoon was about 35. 15 of us got ashore.
Now the survivors remember Tarawa, a moment of glory. An ATN special, Friday night at 8:30. Next on the adventures of Robin Hood, Robin Hood and his men unwittingly stumble into a trap when they rescue a man from being murdered in Sherwood Forest. John Rhys Davies stars as the black-hearted king who perpetrates a devious plot to ensnare Robin and his men into serving in his army. By the time Robin Hood realizes he has been tricked, however, it's too late and he must escape a terrible fate. Don't miss The Adventures of Robin Hood. Coming your way on ATN 1 week from tonight.
you by this station and other public television stations.
To victory on a wave of oil. From that war onwards, oil has also been a major prize of victory. It was oil's ease of handling that first attracted the strategists. Oil could refuel ships at sea, and control of sea routes was vital in the struggle for victory. But even more important, oil could fuel aircraft. And refueling in midair could increase the scope of bombers to bring death and destruction over a wider area. So, as a weapon of war, and increasingly the major prize of war, there were huge profits to be made by those who owned the oil. But where does a multinational oil company stand in times of war?
Whenever you get either a war or an embargo, you get that conflict inside a multinational oil company in which the question of where its loyalties lie then has to come uppermost. In wartime, does it then show its loyalty to the country where it is based, or does it continue to trade with countries which could be closely supplying the enemy?
It was this question of ultimate loyalty that shaped the growth of the oil industry in Europe. For if Rockefeller's Standard Oil of America is rightly called the first multinational, it was closely followed by a European enterprise whose operations would be even more global, the Royal Dutch Shell Group. Came not from exploration and production, but rather from the high seas as an oil trader and transporter.
Slow ahead, please.
Today, Royal Dutch Shell and Exxon compete to be the largest oil company in the world. The global rivalry between Shell and Exxon, derived from Rockefeller's Standard Oil, has lasted almost a century. A Japanese tanker carrying oil from the North Sea docks at Rotterdam, the nearest thing to a home port for the Shell group. But even here in Holland, Shell faces fierce competition from all the major companies, Britain's British Petroleum and the U.S. majors. The same symbols can be seen in every port in the world. Rotterdam symbolizes the industry's vast investments in engineering and equipment. But whereas the Dutch port represents old world stability, oil remains at heart the most political industry, exposed to unpredictable countries around the world, never sure where it really belongs. But oil today is the great global economic force. Yet another reason why the role of the oil companies in wartime or embargo was to become so critical. The famous Shell sign symbolizes a more flexible international currency even than gold or diamonds.
for Shell is everywhere, virtually in every country in the world. And where selling oil to the Arabs might seem paradoxical, producing lubricating oil for Saudi Arabia from this canning plant in Rotterdam is routine to a multinational like Shell. Producing petrochemicals for power from this Shell plant at Dubai, Saudi Arabia. Shell's global strategy started from small beginnings in the East End of London, where the family of Marcus Samuel had made a modest fortune selling jewelry boxes fashioned from exotic seashells from the Far East. In 1893, with the Russian oil field opening up, Samuel commissioned a new range of low-draft tankers to ship Russian oil through the Suez Canal. The tankers, all named after seashells, soon allowed Samuel to undercut Rockefeller's standard oil. In 1897, he founded the Shell Transport and Trading Company. His connection with seashells remaining only in the past. Meanwhile, in the 1850s, a former Rockefeller connected and was cutting his own business case with a little company called Royal Dutch. His name was Henry Jefferson. The Dutch and the British were among the first to explore for oil in Burma and Sumatra. And as the U.S. oil industry was growing in Pennsylvania and Texas, so European oil expertise was being won in the jungles of the Far East. Benton and Samuel merged their respective companies to create Royal Dutch Shell, a formidable challenge to Rockefeller's Standard Oil. The young Benton took the helm as the first managing director, while Samuel became more involved in public life, eventually becoming Lord Mayor of London. Churchill was to declare that the substitution of the internal combustion engine for the horse marked a gloomy milestone in the progress of mankind. But he was among the first to recognize the military implications of oil. He had just been appointed First Lord of the Admiralty and was persuaded by Admiral Sir John Fisher, the first Sea Lord, to test the efficiency of oil for powering warships. He was present at the trials when the engines of the HMS Hannibal were switched from coal to oil. The result was a fiasco, with thick black smoke obliterating everything. But Churchill needed little convincing that oil was the way of the future for powering warships. And although he was sold on oil, he was far from sold on Royal Dutch Shell oil, and even less on America's Standard Oil. In a jingoistic speech to Parliament in June 1914, Churchill argued that foreign-owned companies would always put commercial advantage above Britain's strategic interests. We have no quarrel with Shell, he said. We have always found them ready to oblige at a price. And on that point, we've been treated with the full rigor of the game. We cannot run the risk of getting into the hands of these very good people.
And Churchill made absolutely clear in his own statements that he was not faithful to time. An ordinary commercial oil company. And this was the beginning of the life of the continuing argument that's been there on ever since. It went on during every war, went on during the Falklands, it went on through the oil embargo from 73, when successive political leaders were determined again that they should be independent of their international multinational oil market and oil pricing system.
The solution to Britain's problem with war looming and no surprise of their own was to come not from America, nor Russia, nor from the Far East, but from a land whose oil potential had been charted in the Bible itself. The burning sands of Nebuchadnezzar still ignite as the gases escape from the desert in the modern land. But in the early 1900s, few saw the potential of the lands around the Persian Gulf. This was no matter of country. The oil that seeped to the surface near the Euphrates and Tigris rivers was thought to have no commercial significance, although the locals had been using it for cooking, waterproofing, and building for centuries. It was in the remote of Kiel Strait between Persia and Iraq that the first oil prospectors began work in the early years of the new century. The wild hill country of the Zagros Mountains became home for the crew and their field manager, an English geologist, George Reynolds, always accompanied by his faithful Terry. It took 16 months to complete the first well, a dry hole. But still, Reynolds and his crew worked on through extremes of heat and cold, through plague and bitter disappointment. Now, the heavy drilling equipment and engines and mules go out. By 1907, Reynolds' main backer, William Knox Darcy, was running out of money. When funds finally did run out in April 1908, he cabled Reynolds telling him to stop work. But Reynolds ignored the cable and continued to drill. On May 26th, he finally brought in the first commercial well in the Middle East, the Baju al-Sulaiman. Reynolds cabled the news home to Knox Darcy in a copy of biblical code. See Psalm 104, verse 15, which translated read, that he may bring out of the earth oil to make a cheerful countenance. With only months to go before the outbreak of war, Parliament voted to acquire majority control of Knox Darcy's Anglo-Persian Company. The British Petroleum Company of today is the direct descendant of Knox Darcy's Anglo-Persian. Outside the front entrance of Britannic House, the company headquarters in the City of London, still stands the original relic of the Baju al-Sulaiman, a monument to British wealth created from a far-off land. And still standing on the desert shelf, despite all that's taken place in the 80 intervening years, the western symbols of the oil sands that laid the foundation of Britain's victory in World War I, as well as the foundation of Middle East oil dominance for the rest of the century. Finding the order was a personal triumph for Reynolds. Getting into the market was a triumph of teamwork and engineering for the newly formed Anglo-Persian Oil Company. 120-mile pipeline was laid 15 by the Baju al-Sulaiman and another part of the head of the Arabian Gulf called Abadan. true warfare has changed. They could be removed more quickly from the field of battle as ambulances became more rare.
Thank you.
expressions of sympathy to the Nazis. Scenes like this prize-winning ceremony, for example, have caused the greatest embarrassment.
And I suppose he was